That's Shay405 SMS Radio. We are here. We're hanging out with you until 8 p.m. So hit us up on these phone lines. It is Shay405. You got any questions, comments, all that good stuff. Hey. And as mentioned before.
Wait. All these single ladies out there or married, holler at me.
This is not your personal hookup line, bro.
No,
anyways.
What's sad is it really is, Jay.
I mean, it's really
it really is.
Oh, yeah. Listen. I fuck listeners.
Too much information. Anyways, we got a special guest in the building. We got L'Oreal, MC, star of that Love and Hip Hop show. Yeah. You already know. You
is
know
it L'Oreal?
It's like L'Oreal. You got to say it like that every time you say it.
I ain't gonna listen. I can't get my eyes off the tits.
Got that close.
Not being disrespectful.
But they're covered.
But they're, there's two midgets inside of your shirt.
What's your boob size? I'm just curious.
60 what?
60.
No, it's not a 60. It's a 34. But,
And it's all natural, right?
Yeah.
Because I know when she's on the green screen during the show, you know, people were like, yo, it's getting bigger every episode. I'm like, yo, that sounds stupid.
I'm eating good. Yeah, you know, I got a good bra. I like that bra that I wear for that.
So listen, so you watch the show, right? We all watch the show in the room.
I watch every single episode. I'm actually upset that you wasn't in the last episode.
Yeah, me too. You know, I had a whole little finale thing that they had, and then I guess things changed around and they just took me out and didn't give a fuck. So
well, let's take it back a little bit, because we got introduced to you on the show through, what was like your first intro into the show?
The first intro you saw of me on the show was talking to Erica Mena. And
we're fighting.
We were talking at first.
Yeah, I was cool.
She was asking me for advice with her and Rich Dollars and their relationship, and I gave her advice, and then after that is when the little
she got a little
happened.
Yeah.
And it was so crazy. It's like when you're talking to somebody, you're like so calm, but you come off like such a fucking gangster. I'm like, I would never fuck with her ever.
That's
everybody
calm
says
shit.
That. You know what it is? Yeah, it's because like I really don't take shit, but that doesn't mean I have to act crazy and throw drinks and chairs and shit like that. Like, I just feel like you should know what it is if you know me.
People that usually act up like that, excuse me, is because they're trying to intimidate the next person because they can't throw hands. You know what I'm saying?
What's that saying? Like, the louder the bark or whatever that...
The smaller the bite.
The smaller the bite, yeah. I think that's usually what it ends up being. Well,
go ahead.
I mean, it was displayed in one of the shows because she went up on, what's her name, Winter?
Yeah, I guess.
And you said she read some chapter shit about you. Well, she read something that you did that you wasn't comfortable with. And then you straight stepped to her. Like, that shit better not be on that book when it goes to retail. And to my knowledge, I haven't seen anything on
this that's book. It's in the book, though, right?
Yeah.
It's in the book. I left it in the book.
I'm not really supposed to talk about it because it's in the reunion. But at the same time, the book supposedly is already out. But, you know, I feel like nobody cares about the book, so I didn't really hear
it's
anything.
It's right here.
Oh, well, you got it.
No, I haven't even read the shit. I'm not
but she said...
Hey, listen, we found it in the trash can.
She said you were fucking people and not taking money.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sorry. I wasn't a prostitute ever in my career. That wasn't what I
give a round of
set
applause.
Out to be.
Say
I don't
that
even
again.
Understand how that was a stat.
I was never a prostitute in my career. And, you know, nothing against any prostitutes out there. If that's how you get your money, you know, shout out to you.
I would be a prostitute if I could.
you know, shout out to how I don't never knock anybody else's hustle. But, you know, when you have a hoe calling another girl a hoe, it's just a little bit like, come on, bitch.
I don't believe you.
Yeah.
Have a seat. Who are you? I glanced through the book, right? First of all, Jada Kiss, my nigga, don't ever take a picture with boxers.
Oh, my God.
And Timberlands.
I didn't see any of that. Like, you see more to me. But another thing with the picture thing, well, I don't know about the boxers and all that, but when it comes to pictures, people stop me in the grocery store and be like, can I take a picture with you? And I take the picture.
Yeah,
like, no matter what, they might hang around my friends and, you know, I don't know them like that. So, you know, she has a lot of these stories and I know her for years and, you know, I never heard any of these stories.
Right.
So, you know, I mean, I guess whatever you need to do to make some money. If it's selling your ass, your pussy, if that's what you got to do, you don't got a talent,
no,
more
trust,
power to
you. Trust me, this girl looks bad to me. Like
bad as in bad, not bad meaning good.
No, bad as in super bad.
Nelson actually wanted to put in a complaint about her being on the show at one point. He wanted her removed from the show.
I feel like
she had potato arms. I'm like, what the fuck? And then her heel cracked in half in the middle of
the
show.
Oh, my God.
Did you see this?
Yeah.
But I thought I was the only person.
I'm like, yo, I'm looking for a weight capacity on the fucking front.
She fucking fell.
Red bottoms have a weight capacity.
No, they were brown bottoms.
That shit was funny.
They were brown bottoms. It wasn't brown.
Me and Jay were like, how did that bitch fall so fucking slow? she was like, I'm falling.
She knows what it is at the end of the day. So regardless of if the cameras was on and she felt like that was going to protect her, she knew the truth.
Let me tell you what I didn't like about her. First of all, she was trying to tell you how to run your career.
And had
acting
none.
Like she knew what the fuck was going on. The next thing you know, I'm putting out a book about being a true tramp from the fucking late 90s to the late 2000s.
And that's how it is, you know. And then on top of that, it's like throw somebody under the bus that's closest to you because I have nothing going on. Mm. You know what I mean? And that's just how I looked at it. She seen that, you know, when I spoke to her during the show because we were so cool and she was like, you know, I'm filming every day and this, that, and the third. And we didn't see her. Like, the only episode she was on was the ones with me and trying to throw me under the bus. Right. And it still didn't help her. You know what I mean? Because people just looked at her as a grimy piece of shit or... And that was just it.
Is it safe to say you guys are a wrap? You guys.
Yeah, I mean, who would be... First of all, you don't want to be associated with nobody like that. Mm-hmm. Let alone if they were your friend or not. You know what I mean? Right. You wouldn't go out your way to befriend a fucking fake, watered-down version of Cat Stacks. You know what I mean? So
not even
Superhead, because at least Superhead, we knew she had something going on, even if it was just being a video model. No disrespect, you know what I mean?
We
knew who she was. Like, nobody wants to fuck this girl. Right. So when we see this, it's kind of disrespectful to the rappers you're naming.
I'm a top five pig out here. And I saw this girl on TV and I went rag.
Yeah,
and that says a lot about me. Trust me.
Well, I mean, it's a lot of niggas that wouldn't and that are denying ever. So, you know, you can say what you want, but we don't believe.
I have a quote from you, L'Oreal, where you said about Winter, she used to sleep on Fab's floor and gave everyone head in the entourage.
Yeah.
She's been known as a disgusting whore since the first day I met her, but I don't like to judge people on their reputation.
Yeah.
That's hard.
What and that's all that? Facts.
She gave everybody head in the entourage. Everyone.
Everyone that fucking wanted.
These niggas was there too.
Those my niggas. But I'm gonna keep all the way 100, and I don't know if they're gonna get mad at me. But she tried to holler at both of them.
Oh man.
Look like they got the cameras on now.
Damn. Bring that to the mic. Did you get head from Winter?
Shout out my team. Shout out OT. They didn't want head from her because they just was like, yuck. And shout out my team, OTL.
They was like, no car wash for me, baby.
They was like, please. She was like, please. They was like, fuck out of here, bitch. Take this glass of rosé and kick rock.
Love and Hip Hop season 3, right?
Yeah, season 3. Are you going to be on the next season? Do you know yet?
I'm not really allowed to talk about that yet.
Because the reunion hasn't happened. You're in the reunion, though, right?
All these calls you got going on.
You'll see me in the reunion. You'll see people that you thought were main cast in the audience. And that's it.
Wow. So we
really? I'm trying to think who.
We need to do.
Well, didn't she? I heard she left. Didn't she have to like leave midway because she's pregnant?
Man. Anyway, she's pregnant. Yeah, by who? We don't know.
No, we don't.
She doesn't know. The next show she's gonna be on is Maury.
Dang. I like it. She got a sense of humor too.
Good. She's
all right. Let's do L'Oreal 101, the artist.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where are you from?
I'm from Brooklyn. I was born in Brooklyn, but I was raised in Jersey, so I don't.
What part of
back.
Jersey?
Brick City, Maplewood, South Orange,
Grimy.
Essex County.
Grimy. I don't go to them drive-thrus. Nah, I ain't doing that.
Shout out to Essex County.
Okay, now music-wise, let us know, where did it start? Because we was getting mixed signals from the show with, they were saying, what's his name, Red Cafe?
Yeah, you was Red Cafe's artist,
yeah, right? I used to be signed to Red Cafe for a little bit. I did.
What was the name of his company?
Shakedown.
Yeah, I did that for a little while. I grew out of that. So before that, I was singing. I started off singing. And I got signed to, I dealt with Red Spider first.
That's my people.
Yeah, Red Spider was super dope. He taught me a lot of stuff I knew about recording and things like that. And
he has a real Haitian studio.
Yeah.
It's the color of the flag, everything going on in
there. Yeah, well, when he was on Spring and Six, that's when I was really, like, in there recording and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And, like I said, I went to Shakedown for a few years, and I grew out of it. I just felt like, you know, he was focusing on himself, Red Cafe, who's he?
He's still trying to come on. Exactly.
I just felt like I couldn't be behind somebody that was pushing me back, so it's like focus on himself.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I just felt like there was so much more things I had to offer and things I had to put out that he was trying to kind of tell me to wait. Right. And I don't feel like I have to wait to have anybody else put me on.
Right.
Like, you know, thank you for whatever you've done. Yeah, mm-hmm. Thank you for the opportunity. And it's all love, no hate at all. Mm-hmm. But I just felt like I could do it on my own a little bit.
So, but when he signed with Diddy, didn't you feel like that was going to be like, there was some hope for all of y'all?
No, when he signed with Diddy, I actually felt like it was going to actually be a problem because I thought we were doing good on our own.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know, and I feel like once he signed to Diddy, then it was going to be, okay, now what does Diddy want to do?
Now you're on schedule. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You're on Diddy's schedule.
And then at the time, Diddy has started to help manage or whatever was going on with Nicki Minaj, mm-hmm. and he first got Ross, and I just felt like that just put me back like so far, and I was right. like, you know what, let me just focus on myself.
Right.
He's focused on himself, you know, we needed to part ways, and that was something we agreed on.
Yeah. Well, before she even, you know, got with Red Cafe and all of that, she has a dope story as how she even got started in the music industry, because you was working literally in the industry, right?
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about that.
My cousin...
You was on the street team?
Yeah, I was on
the
street team.
She did it all.
Okay. My cousin, his name was Ryan Moorhead, he worked for Gary Beach at Sony,
right.
and I came in as an intern illegally. Like, I wasn't even, you know, they had to buzz me in every day instead of me having my own pass. And
right.
I worked my way up. I went from running around and being in David McPherson's office and, mm-hmm. you know, just trying to help wherever I could to them giving me a position as on the street team working for Paul Ambrose
right.
and Malcolm Miles, who was there at the time. And,
Malcolm.
You know, it was cool because I learned so much, and that was one thing I knew being up there. I was going
to
get
grassroots
cool.
of how to break a record.
Absolutely. I knew all the DJs.
Right.
I was sneaking them vinyls because
right.
that's when it was vinyls.
Right.
It wasn't, you know what I mean? The internet wasn't like it was today. Mm-hmm. And those same DJs show me love to today. They still help me. And, you know, I went from Sony to Bad Boy. I was a temp at Bad Boy. I worked at Slip and Slide for a little bit. And, you know, I just kept my connections and, you
right.
know, tried to do whatever I could to learn
right.
the industry. You
right.
know what I mean? So I feel like as an artist, that helped me a lot. Like, regardless of what people seen on the show, it's a television show.
Right.
You know what I mean? I have a lot of history working in labels and in the industry, and I feel like that's what helps
me. Well, that's why I wanted them, you know, the people to hear her story, because I don't want people to get it twisted where she's just a pretty face and then Rat Cafe picked her up from like the street. Like, nah,
absolutely.
She was already working.
Yeah,
she,
I mean,
she was hustling. She was doing what she had to do within the industry, actually having a job.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then how was it that they discovered you, though? Because I think that was dope too.
Well, with Red Cafe, Chris Green was actually his manager.
Shout out to Chris, that's my
And
dude.
He was working at Sony. I used to run around rapping for everybody and whatever. An intern called me out and was like, you can't rap, whatever, whatever. And kind of made me go back and forth with him, and I aired him out.
Right.
And I wasn't even a battle rapper. It was just like verse for verse.
Yeah.
And then from there, it was just kind of like, you know, everybody fucked with me. I ran into Kanye West. He heard my song and he was like, you know what? You're dope, but your name's terrible. You know what I'm saying? My name was Ricochet.
Don't laugh at me.
I had a dope little
said,
I was
Ricochet,
like, Ricochet, that's the name you should know. Jersey, that's the town you should call. I was dead ass, though. And then, you know, they let me know, and they were just like, no, that's not a hot name. And then, you know, I kept running in the Red Cafe and the clubs and stuff like that, and Chris Green was like, yo, this girl is dope. Like, I don't know if you know her, but she's on Life Jennings record,
right.
and that's just from me being in Sony. I was on a Big Country King record, and you know, that was just me by myself.
Be easy with that name. That nigga didn't sell no record.
At the time, you know, he had the,
yeah.
they had the whole,
Grand Hustle,
this is 2005,
yeah,
by
yeah.
the way.
Right.
So this was, Grand Hustle was totally different.
Right.
So, you know, they threw me on that record, and then Hottest in the Hood, that was the first thing I really got on that was kind of
We got that here?
The remix.
We got the remix of
Hollywood.
She killed that shit. With Busta Rhymes and Lloyd Banks. And, you know, that was like a blessing to me, you know. And then the Tonight record with Fab.
That was a standout record, though, because it was like, who's this chick?
Everybody.
Her voice was just different. Mm. Stood out.
No,
like,
you have a very powerful
this?
Voice.
Thank you. Yeah. He was literally like, I had no clue.
I would hate for you to be my girl and we get into a fucking argument.
Right, yeah.
I overpower everybody in an argument. Unless I just feel like the argument is a worth it. Then I'm like, all right, motherfucker. Like,
what up? So let's talk about currently your music you got going on. I see like a new video every week. Like, what are you doing? Yeah. How you working?
I'm grinding. Yeah. I got to put that work in just to let people know this shit ain't a game. Okay. So I got a project coming out April 15th. It's called Billboard Bitch. Dope. Bitch with a Y.
Damn.
And I dropped the first single already, Benjamin's. It's available on iTunes. Okay. And I'm singing on that
record. Independent? Or?
Yeah, independent on OTL, Out of Day League Entertainment, my label.
Nice.
So,
I think now is the time to strike because I don't really feel like we have a female lyricist at this time, considering, and I'm not disrespecting her, but Nicki Minaj has kind of crossed over to pop music.
Yeah.
So we don't really have that female lyricist right now in the hip-hop game. So this might be your time, L'Oreal.
Absolutely. I think so, too. So that's why I'm working so hard. And, you know, I'd rather put records out and videos out and sleep. And, you know, because I believe in this shit and I think it's going to pop. So,
definitely.
You know, like I said, April 15th, that Billboard Bitch is going to come out and I feel like it's going to, you know, change shit up a little bit.
You definitely shake bubbling shit up and making noise now, definitely. So, do you want to hear her do a freestyle?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's only right.
We always make everybody make her do a freestyle. So
all right.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
What
you got something over there, Thorough?
Mm-hmm.
You want a beat? You want something hot?
I mean, I do it without a beat.
Do it with a beat, man. Let's do it in an orderly fashion.
All right.
Well, while we're waiting for that, L'Oreal, do you feel like this has helped your, like, music career, the show, or?
I would definitely say that Love & Hip Hop gave me a platform.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't necessarily say it was for music or anything. I feel like Love & Hip Hop for new artists may be a bit of a setback instead of a, you know, step
up. Why do you say that?
I mean, I say that because when you see a lot of people on the show, it's like, okay, I have a single. And it's more so just a hobby thing, you know. And I do this shit for real. I've been doing this shit for years. And, you know, when I see people take it lightly and they're like, oh, she has a single just because they're trying to get, you know, a dollar off. They all right, I respect. Yeah, I respect everybody grind, but I'm not playing when I do this.
Right.
So that's what makes it way different because people are expecting like, okay, well, Kim, what's her name? She had Don't Be Tardy for the Party.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
That's
a reality person. So they look at it like we're going to use this just to get any kind
but
of money we
gimmick,
want.
And it's a gimmick.
And I don't never want anybody to look at me and be like, well, you know, I ain't hear her before. That's a gimmick. Like, nah, I've been doing this shit for real.
But I mean, it's just, I mean, anybody who, you know, I think it was a good move for you because it was, you know, nationwide. People were able to
absolutely
see who you were. And
absolutely.
It's not like if they Googled you, nothing was going to pop up. If they looked you up, then they saw your body of work that you've been doing it. You know what I'm saying?
I feel like people on the East Coast knew who you were.
That's true.
We was fucking with you already.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
But
y'all definitely.
Everybody now knows who the fuck you are, L'Oreal. Mm-hmm. So it's an amazing thing. It's a great thing for you.
The platform was great.
Right.
I would say the platform was great, and me having the show improve was not a problem for me.
I mean, and you carried yourself well on the show, and I think people was like, I want to see more of her.
No, but she's right, because I'm going to tell you right now, I love to hear it. That's my people's. But the moment that I want to take my life and put that handgun in my head, that record Devil's the one I'm going to be playing in the background.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
So
fast.
I like the record.
Wait, are you for
real? I do. I like that record.
Listen, Tahiri
is my
people's.
What happens? Are you hearing that?
I like it.
I love Tahiri, but
listen, Tahiri is my people's, but I heard Cats. There's no rhythm in that.
Yo. I don't even know.
You know, she says it to herself. She was just playing around with the music. And I think there's nothing wrong with that. You know what I mean? But then you got some people on the show that's dead ass.
We're talking about
Eric. That's dead ass.
Yeah,
you know
I'm just
mean?
Curious. Did you see the video she put out?
Oh my
come on.
God.
I did.
I don't have time to waste.
Yo, you
I
like that, Nelson.
I like
that.
Time to waste.
He saw it and he's been watching it ever since.
Nelson,
he liked that.
Yes. I wanted to ask you about that. How many times did you jerk off to that video, Nelson?
It was a soft porn.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I can't speak on that, how many times I did that, but trust me, I did watch the shit out of that video.
But anyway,
I was wishing I was the water.
Well, we know you're a titty guy, so we see that much.
Well, let's get back to
trying to use
them
just as a
speed bag. Oh, my Lord, Jesus Christ. Listen, do we have that ready, Thorough?
Let's go.
All right, let's do it.
Okay.
Shade 405, L'Oreal.
Yeah. L'Oreal. smoking weed out of Lambo. Yeah, I got a hell of a handle. And I look good in the middle of scandal. Canceling bitches, go new jack. I'm coming through, little nigga, get the fuck back. My rack stack and my poom poom fat and my gold yard stuff. Huge boobs, I'm all at. Ooh. Call that showing off, gotta do more. I own damn near everything in the store. Never fraternize a low life whore. Saying what you gonna do, fuck you waiting for. And lately I've been thinking about the power of the buck. If it ain't about money, I don't never give a fuck. Valentino Queen, Crackadale Celine. I am the club, I am the scene. I got my Cali weed on the East Coast. Such a sweet thing, throwing L's up. Yeah, still a G thing,
That's dope.
Yay! You in the radio and all that. Let's go. That's a must. Let's go.
She just gave me a Woody.
Oh, Lord.
Because I said something about titties. I know what that is.
L'Oreal's hanging out with us.
L'Oreal.
You a fan now. You a fan.
Listen, when Don... I'm going to be 100%. When Don Juan called me about... Yo, you want to interview L'Oreal? I just started snoring. I'm to him on the line like, yo, son, what the fuck? I'm telling you, yo, she can rap. Like,
but that's because of that Love and Hip Hop that got you thinking that. Yeah, said.
Again.
You see?
For me, every record that comes out of them shows, I really just put them to the side. I wait till them shits build up organically.
And you should. You know, you got to show and prove. Not just because it's on TV one time.
Yeah.
Does that make anybody hot? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So you got to put in that work. And once people understand that, hence the other artists on the show that tried to, you know, revive their career, do whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you still didn't put in no work. So nobody cares. That's just how I feel. They got comfortable being reality stars. I'm not a reality star. I'm a rapper.
Preach.
You write your own shit?
Yeah, I write all my own stuff. You have to, as a female, I feel like, in order to get that respect.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I try to make that clear. Like, I work hard. I don't give a fuck if niggas is aggravated with me. Like, this bitch took 4 hours to write the verse. So what, nigga? My shit hot. Fuck you.
Did you ever
play my shit?
Have you ever written for anybody else? I'm curious.
They tried to get me to write for someone else one time as a female rapper, too. And, you know, after I was done with the song, I was like, nah, yo, this shit hot. This mom. I'm
going to keep it.
I'm stingy.
It's good money, though.
Yeah, I'd rather keep it to myself, you know?
So I'm going to ask you a music question.
Yeah. Okay.
If it was the last two CDs you can have in the world in your car, it doesn't have to be hip-hop.
Okay.
It doesn't have, it's whatever genre, but your two, hands down, from track one to the last track, just the body of work, what's your two CDs?
Okay.
And why?
I would say Kanye West.
Which album?
Which one? What was the second one? The Graduation? What was that?
Late Registration.
Late registration.
That was the one with Drive Slow and all that on. I love that. I love Kanye West. So it's like, it could have been any one of his albums. The first, second, not the singing one too much. I mean, I like that one, but I like when he gets ignorant
and curses
people.
That shit was terrible. I couldn't have sex to it.
Yeah, like the Heartless track and shit was cool, but it wasn't like my favorite. Mm-hmm. I think like Graduate, any Kanye West album, just give me one except for the singing one. And, one more. I'm sorry.
It could be a classic. It could be, you know what I mean?
I so want to say Big, Ready to Die.
Double CD?
Because, you know, I got two CDs, so right there that makes three. And that's a classic. Like, you can't ever go wrong with Big, first of all, and then Ready to Die. Like, that's just...
I had an argument with a DJ the other day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was Ready to Die or Life After Death. And I had to go with Life After Death.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
That
Life
double
After
CD
Death,
from top to bottom was ridiculous.
You're right.
Like, I felt like, you know, God bless the dead Big, but he showed his ass on that double CD.
He did.
Like, every record was dope.
You're right. I feel like Big is so great, like... And, like, I can't think of any one record he put out that I didn't like, actually. Mm. So, anything from Big. Big and Kanye West, I would say, could do no... Well, Kanye could do something wrong with it.
Yeah.
Since Kim Kardashian. Like, he did. I'm sorry, I just had to say it, but...
Who's a male rapper that you want to work with? Like, who are you looking to work with?
I mean, Drake. I think Drake is... No, you know what? I'm going to take that back, because I feel like that's generic. Sorry, Drake. I love you still. I really, really, really am a big fan of Kendrick Lamar.
Yes.
I think he is sick. And, you know, his CD, how he formatted that with the minivan and a mom Duke calling. Yeah. Like, and the pops wanting his dominoes. Like, I just, like, I feel him. Like, for some reason, I felt like I was from Compton. I'm not. But, you know, when I listen to that CD, I could really feel him. Like, I feel like I'm in the van with him and his friends getting shot at and shooting at niggas. And I just love Kendrick Lamar.
But then let me ask you this. You've done the whole thing of being under somebody, you know what I'm saying, when you were over at Cafe. And now you're doing the solo thing, you know, your own label. You're doing, you know, independent. Would you at any point consider going on a major? And if so, for, like, what crew can you see yourself working with?
I would definitely not turn down any right offers. Of course. You know, I'm pretty comfortable being independent and being in control of my own stuff.
Would you go to Good Music since you're such a big Kanye fan?
Yeah. I think I would, but at the same time, I wouldn't want to mess up the fact that I'm such a big Kanye fan. Mm-hmm. You know, I might get over there and be like, yes, Good Music. And the next thing you know, the nigga's like, bitch, here you go. Your spot on the shelf. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And no, thank you. You know what I mean? I think right now I'm comfortable where I'm at, being in control of my own stuff and being independent. Sure. And, you know, I want to just see how this works out for right now. And, you know, like I said, nobody's going to turn down the right offer.
Right.
But as of right now, I'm cool.
Good. Well, she got the new mix. Yeah, she got the new mixtape, though. Shout that out real quick.
Billboard Bitch, April 15th. Benjamin's is that lead single. The follow-up is Tear the Club Up. I got Problem, my homeboy from L.A., Out Gang, you know what it is.
Yo, he can rap.
That's my nigga. That's my fam. Him and Bad Luck, like, we the same squad, whatever, so.
He was here this week.
Yeah, he was just here. We was in the studio, what, 2 days ago? Yeah, we just did a mean-ass record. Two records, actually, that's going to be on my EP, so, you know, make sure you check out for that. And, you know, Billboard Bitch, OTL, out of they league. Let's go.
Once again, L'Oreal.
Well, listen, be sure to hit her up and follow her on that Twitter and Instagram. Yeah,
Twitter, Instagram, website, everything is starring L'Oreal, L-O-R-E-L. Artists, make sure you stay consistent.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, you know, make sure you hit me up, Instagram, all of that shit. I'm on there.
And
so,
if you're thirsty to see her, because she's a cutie pie, you can see her this Monday on the reunion, right?
Absolutely. This Monday and the following Monday is a two-part episode.
Oh,
so,
man,
you know, check me out in the reunion.
So what's going to happen in the reunion? Just tell us right now what's happening.
I got the best shoes. I can say that much.
Hands down, you got them.
Hands down.
And you own them, right?
Yeah, I own them. Own them. Okay. And I paid 7 stacks for them, bitches. Step your chicken up. And I got the receipt and the box and all that.
A lot of the receipts is Rent the Runway. On that Rent the Runway.
Not only rent, but listen, not only rent, but, you know, this should be a little cheapy. And
paint the bottoms, paint the
crazy, little fake, Steve Madden.
Daisy.
A little knockoff-ish, a little blacklisted from stores-ish.
Damn.
Oh, yeah. Okay, we just gonna leave it at that.
All right, so let's get into one of our other joints. Which one is this one, guys?
Every day.
That's why I date white chicks. They wear Skippies and shit.
Oh man.
Jesus Christ.
You
know, I'm not wearing Skippies. I just want to make that clear.
Oh,
right,
yeah.
Now,
see, don't do that to Jenny Boone.
I'm not wearing Skippies.
We're offended over here.